friends, so now we start with Ohm's law and combination of resistance. So in previous video we discussed about the electric current charge. So now we discuss here Ohm's law. So scientist Ohm's gives one relation between potential difference and current in an electric circuit. So whenever any electric circuit is to be there, so there is one relation between current and potential. So according to Ohm's, if temperature like physical quantity is constant, then potential difference, that is V, across conductor is proportional to current flow in the circuit. That means potential difference V is directly proportional to I. This relation also indicates that when we increase the potential with the help of battery, so current is also increased in same manner. That means when we use 2 volt battery, so current is up to the order of 2. Similarly, when we increase the voltage, so current is also increased in same manner. And when we remove this proportional sign, constant is to be added. So V is equals to here IR. This relation is called here Ohm's law. So this relation also states that current I is to be equal to V divided by R, and here R is called resistance of the circuit. And this proportionality constant R, when we plot the graph between current and voltage, we take 2 axes X and Y, and because of proportional relation V and I, so when voltage and current is to be plotted, so it gives a straight line. This straight line indicates that R equals to resistance. So in practical, we take one circuit. In this circuit, battery, one key, and we connect here emitter as well as 1 volt meter across the resistance wire. So what we see in this diagram, in this figure, electric circuit, a battery is to be connected, a resistance R, ammeter, voltmeter, key, and rheostat RH. So as I already mentioned, ammeter is always connected in series and voltmeter is always connected in parallel. So in order to practically prove this relation, we make a table then we observe the reading. So when we insert the key, I current flows throughout the circuit, and this current is to be detected by an emitter, and corresponding voltage is to be denoted by V. So first we change the position of rheostat and note down the reading in ammeter and voltmeter. Say 2 volt and current is suppose 4 ampere. Okay. In next step, again we drag the position of rheostat. That means we have to change via dragging the position of rheostat, and again we observe the reading in ammeter and voltmeter. Suppose it is 3 volt in voltmeter and 6 ampere current in ammeter. Now similarly we take the third one reading and fourth one via changing the position of rheostat. Now in order to calculate the resistance, we take the ratio of V to I. So 2 by 4, this is 1 by 2. Similarly 3 and 6, again it is 1 by 2. So every time we get here the same half, half and half. So this indicates that voltage is to be directly proportional to I, and this verifies the Ohm's law. Then we plot the graph between voltage and current, so it is again a straight line. So whenever a conductor follows this Ohm's law, this is said to be ohmic substance. So most of the conductors follow the Ohm's law, that is why it is also called ohmic substance or ohmic conductors. Next we come to combination of resistance. You have to combine the resistance in an electric circuit. So we have two ways to connect the resistance. Number one is there, series, and number 2 is here, parallel, and both the way there is a slightly difference. In series, resistance are connected one by one, that means R1 resistance is to be connected to R2, then R3 and so on. Now all the resistance are connected to a battery, one key. So such kind of arrangement is said to be series arrangement, when two or more than resistance are connected one by one. So what we see here, when key plug key is to be inserted, I current flow in the circuit. Okay. Now because of different resistance is to be there, so voltage is to be different. Say V1 voltage for R1 resistance, for R2 it is V2, and for R3 it is V3. We may also check by, if we insert one voltmeter parallel to each resistance, this also indicates voltage is to be different for different resistance. So as you know that energy is to be conserved. So when V voltage is to be given by the battery, so V is to be equal to V1, V2 and V3. Now V is to be equal to, as per Ohm's law, I into R, I into R1, I into R2 and I into R3. When we take I common, so we get here R is equal to R1, R2 and R3. So we may conclude that here there are two results. Number one, current is to be constant throughout the circuit, and number two, net resistance or equivalent resistance is sum of individual resistance, that is R1, R2 and R3. Next we come to parallel combination. In parallel combination, two or more resistance are connected in such a way, first end is to be connected to a common point, say A. Similarly, second end is to be connected via a common point B. R1, R2 and R3. Now this resistance is connected to battery and key. Now because of battery B, I current is to be flow. Now this I current at A point is split in three parts, or we can say in three branch, I1, I2 and I3. Now all the three currents I1, I2 and I3 again meet to same point B, common terminal B, and it gives I. So what we may observe here, I current is to be split in three parts, I1, I2 and I3. Again if we apply the Ohm's law, so IB is equals to IR. So I is equals to B divided by R. So I is to be replaced by B by R. This equals to B by R1, B by R2 and B by R3. Now we cancel out both the sides, then we get 1 by R, this equals to 1 by R1, 1 by R2 and 1 by R3. So again we may conclude that two conclusions. Number one is to be there. Now I current is to be split. That means B is to be constant. That means during the parallel combination, voltage is to be constant or potential difference is to be constant. And second one, net resistance is equal to sum of individual reciprocal resistance of each R1, R2 and R3. So when we compare both series and parallel, so we find that series resistance is more as compared to parallel one. So practically for household purpose, we use parallel combination. The reason behind parallel combination is that if suppose one of the appliances is to be break, so rest the appliances are in working position. That is why we always take parallel combination in household wiring. Thank you.